it's very difficult for me to make that sacrifice to go, let's say, be somebody's bench coach or go manage in the minor league somewhere for 3 or 4 or 5 years.
And on the line right now, you know him as a World Series ring holder with the Boston Red Sox. I know him for a lot of things, but mostly for baseball. But you're not going to believe what he's doing now. Gabe Kapler, I haven't talked to you. You're not going to believe how long it's been. You might not even remember.
I'm sure it's been too long. Let's put it like that, CJ. But it's always a pleasure to have an opportunity to chat with you.
Well, thank you. It was probably in right around the World Series. The last time I was with the F Network, you and I spoke. And there aren't that many women who do sports talk, so it's kind of good for me. People remember me only because I'm one of a few.
Well, your name is fairly recognizable, too. You have a stage name. TJ Silas is a recognizable name.
I guess so. You know what's funny, Gabe? When I first started going by CJ, there were two reasons I did it. One, my stepfather always called me CJ, Miss CJ. I don't know why. And then when I got into the business 24 years ago, I didn't want anyone to know I was a woman, because if they knew I was a woman, they might not open my resume tape or look at my resume. So I went by CJ because I wanted at least people to give me a chance. But if they saw Carolyn Joe, which is my real name, they might have been like, yeah, a woman doing this? Whatever. So they might not have checked out.
That's so disappointing that even 25 years ago, that was the case.
Yes.
20 years ago.
Yes, and it is disappointing. But the cool thing about it is that I can look back and I can say I persevered. I mean, how many people get to do what they want to do their whole life?
I know, and I kind of envy your job. It's exciting to talk sports all the time, to live in San Luis Obispo. What a life.
One of my worst favorite memories of you, I'm not going to lie, is when you robbed Russell Martin of that catch, when you fell into the left field seats. I think it was 08 or 09. I think you even got an award for that play.
That was 2008. Yeah, that was actually a really happy homecoming for me, because it had been a while since I had played at Dodger Stadium in front of my friends and family, and I just had a great series. So that was kind of the pinnacle of that series, was that home run that Russell Martin didn't have.
And you kind of ended your career, sort of, with the Dodgers, because wasn't that the last team you signed a deal with? It was minor league or something, but wasn't that really your last team?
My last spring training. I went to camp with the Dodgers in 2011.
Right.
Ned Colletti was awesome to me, and I'll always be grateful for that opportunity. I hounded him for the better part of a month and said, look, Ned, just give me an opportunity to come into camp. I know I'd be up against it, but I really want to play at home. I really want the opportunity to play in front of my friends and family on a regular basis. And if I don't make the club, I'll totally understand, but just give me the opportunity. I came into camp with the Dodgers. I actually performed pretty well. It came down to myself and Xavier Paul, who was out of options. And for me, I would have been much more expensive and wouldn't have nearly the upside as X did. So I actually believe that the Dodgers made the right decision, but I was just grateful for the opportunity to go to camp and have that experience.
So you managed for the Red Sox in their organization in 07, but then you went back to play, and then you mentioned managing again at the beginning of our interview. Is that something you think you're going to do someday?
It absolutely is. It's on my radar. It's very difficult for me to make that sacrifice to go, let's say, be somebody's bench coach or go manage in the minor league somewhere for 3 or 4 or 5 years and then make that sacrifice. And the sacrifice ultimately is not getting to watch my kids play football. So, and I'm not willing to make that sacrifice. I love the game of football too much. I love my kids too much. I love my family too much to make the sacrifice that I'm going to go manage in the minor leagues for 3 or 4 years and then be on somebody's staff for 3 or 4 years. I mean, that's a huge commitment that I'm not ready to make.
He's Gabe Kapler. He's a friend of mine, and now he's a friend of the CJ Silas Show on the Central Coast on ESPN Radio 1280. Thank you, bud.
Thank you so much, CJ.